Today, I'm going to talk about one quick, simple, precise, and cheap way to monitor the temperature in your home using a smart sensor and home assistant. It is going to be a do-it-yourself video in which I'll show you the steps, the needed components, how to connect them, and how to add everything in probably the best smart home hub available at the moment called Home Assistant. As end result, I'll have a smart DIY sensor connected to my Wi-Fi, which will allow monitoring in real time the temperature, the atmospheric pressure, and eventually the humidity. Based on these readings, I can create endless home automations like turn on or off the heater, the AC, or something else. But more on that later, because now I'll list the components that I used and their incredibly expensive prices. The first thing I needed for the smart temperature sensor that will work perfectly with Home Assistant is a D1 Mini. This IoT board will be connected to my Wi-Fi and it will be powered by one micro USB cable. I will install ESPHome software on the D1 Mini so I can control it, and I will attach one high precision, low power digital pressure and temperature sensor on it. The price of the BMP280 is under a dollar. The average price of the D1 Mini ESP8266 in AliExpress is around $3 US or even less. The micro USB cable is around $2 US. Three thin wires are also needed, where I recommend three male-to-male jumper wires. Of course, if you already have a spare micro USB cable and some wires, you can use them instead. The total cost of everything that is needed for this DIY smart temperature sensor for Home Assistant is around $6 US. The links of all of the needed things can be found in the video description, and if you happen to buy something from there, I will receive a small commission from your purchase with no additional cost for you, which is a great way to support this channel. Anyways, let's clear one more thing before we begin. There are two types of temperature sensors that are pretty similar, and both can be used in this project with the same success. The first sensor, and the one that I'm going to use in this video, is called BMP280, and it can measure the temperature and the atmospheric pressure. Where the second sensor is called BME280, and it can measure temperature, pressure, and humidity. BME280 is slightly more expensive, and it is a slightly better choice overall. I'm saying all of that as I didn't knew that there are two almost identical in terms of names and form factor sensors, so I bought some BMP280 instead of BME280, thinking that I found a great deal due to the lower price of the BMP280. So, I got tricked. But you can make an informed decision about what sensor you really need based on the information that I just shared. Nevertheless, I'm interested in temperature readings only for now, and the BMP280 sensor is actually and unintentionally a better choice for me. In any ways, I will link the ESPHome code for both sensors in the video description and in my website, so you can choose whatever sensor suits you best. With that being said, let's see that code and upload it on a D1 Mini board, which is super easy. I'll open my ESPHome dashboard and I'll create a new device. I'll click continue. The name of the device will be temperature sensor BMP280. One of the easiest way to manage ESPHome devices is by using the ESPHome dashboard. And there is a nice chain here that can seem a bit complicated at first, but actually it is quite simple. So, one of the easiest way to get ESPHome dashboard is by installing it with two clicks in Home Assistant. I even have a full video tutorial about that, and I'll link it right here. The next link in that chain is the actual Home Assistant installation type, which should be Home Assistant OS or supervised, because they allow installation of add-ons, including ESPHome Dashboard add-on. Not to worry, I got you covered here as well. I'm excited to announce that I'll be hosting a webinar exactly on this topic, the installation types of Home Assistant. The webinar is all free, and if you're interested in attending it, please type this URL in the browser or click on the link in the video description to register. Back to our chain, I have installed ESPHome Dashboard add-on on my Home Assistant OS, and now I'll create a new device. And this will be the name of my Wi-Fi and the Wi-Fi password. I'll click Next. I'll pick a specific board because I know what my board is. The exact model is D1 Mini. It is somewhere at the bottom of the list. Here it is. Wemos D1, R2 and Mini. This is the correct board. Actually, mine is Wemos D1 Mini. And I'll click Next. And my configuration is created. But I'll skip this and I'll not install anything. And I'll go directly to my newly created ESPHome device and I'll click Edit. I'll delete this encryption key because I don't need that. I'll delete also the OTA password because I don't need that as well. And on the last line, I'll paste this code. Don't try to remember this code, just get it from the video description. Basically, this code will create two sensors, the temperature sensor and the pressure sensor. This is exactly the same as in the ESPHome documentation. This is the same code from here. The only difference is that I added this part, the I2C bus. This part is needed in order everything to work. The other thing that I change is this address. The possible options are 77 by default or 76. As you can see here, defaults to 77. Another address can be 76, but because my chip doesn't want to work with 77, I change it to 76 and everything is now fine.
BMP280 temperature sensor is not yet attached. Here is how both components, D1 Mini and BMP280, should be wired. And by the way, the same wiring can be used for the BME280 sensor. I have connected everything like this. G on the D1 Mini to ground on the BMP280 sensor, D1 to SCL and D2 to SDA. Also, 3 volts on the D1 Mini to VCC on the BMP280 sensor.
And I'm ready, I can click Save. And then I can click Install. Now I have to plug my D1 Mini into the device where ESPHome Dashboard and Home Assistant are installed. Now select the third option. The device is found on USB 0. I'll select it. And the installation of ESPHome firmware begins. It can take around 1 or 2 or 3 minutes. I just have to wait for the process to finish. While I'm waiting for this to finish, I'll show you the BME280 configuration, which is pretty similar to the one that I used. You can find it as well in the ESPHome website or in my video description. The only difference with the one that I used is this platform. It is BME instead of BMP. And I have one more sensor, humidity sensor here. Again, the address can be 77 or 76. And again, I2C bus is required for this to work. So instead of this code right here for the BMP, if you have BME280, you have to use this code. That's all. The installing of the ESPHome on the D1 Mini is now complete. And I'm ready to test this. I'll click on stop button. I'll close this window. And as you can see, my device temperature sensor BMP280 is online. I can see the logs wirelessly. And here it is. These are the readings. The state of the temperature sensor is 22.44. And this is the atmospheric pressure. Good, it is working.
Although the temperature sensor is now ready to be used and it can stay that way, I'm not finished yet. I'm going to add web server so I can check the temperature readings from my browser by just typing the IP of the D1 mini device.
I want to show you how you can quickly edit the ESPHome configuration and how to upload it afterwards. For example, I can add a web server, that's a default HTTP port. I can click save, install, and because my device is already provisioned and online and it is connected to my Wi-Fi, I can upload the changes wirelessly by clicking on the first option. Over there, upload of the new changes are now complete, and I can try to open this device. I'll copy the name of the device and I'll type .local, and here it is. This is my new device and its readings. The temperature and the pressure, and this is the log. Everything seems fine. If I go back to my home assistant now, I'll stop this. I will press the C button. I'll type integrations. And inside here, I can find my new device auto-discovered by Home Assistant. I can click Configure, Submit, Finish. And now my device is somewhere here under ESPHome Integration. Here it is, one device with two entities. And I have the temperature and the pressure readings in Home Assistant. I can add them to Dashboard. And I can create automations based on these readings. For example, if BMP280 temperature changes, do something. For example, start the heating or stop the heating or whatever. I know that smart home technology can be overwhelming with all the different terms and technologies out there. That's why I've created a smart home glossary to help you better understand the terminology used in the smart home industry. This glossary is absolutely free and you can instantly download it from my website. The link can be found on the screen and in the video description. Now, back to the action. The next optional thing is a 3D printed case for the newly created DIY smart temperature sensor for Home Assistant. You can find some links to tested by me 3D models in the video description. And if you manage to make your own smart temperature sensor thanks to D1 Mini and BMP or BME280 sensor and this video, please type hashtag THOWN in the comments so everyone will know that you made it and can congratulate you for the efforts. Be sure to check my other smart DIY sensors playlist and subscribe for my channel for more updates. Thank you for watching. I'm Kirill and I'm done speaking. Bye!